Hi friends, welcome to Beauty Infinite. So today I will share with you another chicken dish, and this dish is super yummy and tasty and one of my absolute favorite. This is known as chicken do pyaza, and this tastes absolutely divine with rice and roti. So if you want to know how I came up with this dish and how you can prepare it easily at home, then please keep on watching. So the very first ingredient we're going to require is chicken. I've taken 700 grams of chicken, washed it and kept it aside. Then I've taken 3 to 4 large onion and sliced them into fine slices and kept it aside again. Finally, I've taken 2 big onions and cut it into bulb sizes, that is just separated the layers from one another, and I'm going to keep it aside. Next, I will take 6 to 7 red chili. These are dry red chili. Then I will take 150 gram of yogurt. Then I will make a fine paste of 1 medium-sized garlic, 1 small piece of ginger and 5 to 6 red chili, and paste it in the blender and keep it aside. Then I will take some jeera or cumin seed. For masala, we are going to take turmeric powder, jeera powder or cumin powder, and coriander powder. We will also take salt to taste and sunflower oil for cooking the dish. Then we are going to take 1 whole lemon juice and some freshly chopped coriander. Now we are going to start preparing the dish. So for this I have taken a kara and I have added in some sunflower oil. And once the oil has heated up, I have added 1.5 tablespoon of cumin seed. Once the cumin seed starts spluttering, I have added in all the chopped onion. First we are going to fry this onion until they are all nicely brown in color. So I have added in some salt to taste and start frying the onion. Once the onion is brown like this, you can add the rest of the ingredient. So first we are gonna go ahead and add the paste which we kept aside. So we are gonna add the whole paste into the dish, and into it we are also gonna add 1 tablespoon of turmeric, because turmeric was gonna give a good color to the whole dish. Then we are gonna saute this for a few minutes until the raw smell of garlic and ginger just goes away. Once the saute is done, I will add the rest of the ingredient. So first I'm going to add in the yogurt. Along with the yogurt, I will also add 1 tablespoon of cumin powder and 1/2 a tablespoon of coriander powder, and then I'm going to mix it all well together and put the chicken into the whole gravy. I will then coat the chicken well with the whole masala so that the masala enters the chicken really nicely. Mix it well for 1 to 2 times so that each chicken pieces are coated well with the masala. Then I will add 1/2 cup of water into this, and also 5 to 6 green chili chopped into 5 pieces. Then I will mix this all well together. Cover the dish with a lid and keep it for 10 to 15 minutes until the chicken is cooked and the masalas are all fried. Now you can see the chicken is well cooked and the masala is all cooked as well, since oil is floating on top. So on the next stove, I'm going to heat some mustard oil, and into this I'm going to add the red chilies which we have taken earlier, and then we are going to add the onion bulbs, and once they are light brown slightly, we're going to add this whole mixture into the chicken dish. Just maintain a distance while adding this, because you do not want oil to splutter at you. So then I'm going to mix all this together, and this is going to add such a nice flavor to the whole dish. The aroma is going to be very yummy, very, very delicious. You can see how beautiful it looks. Now I'm adding in the coriander and the lime juice. Now I'm going to mix it all well together. I'm going to shimmer it for 3 to 4 minutes more so that the raw smell of the coriander just goes away and it gets coated with masala. You do not want it to be overcooked, and finally, once it is done, I'm going to remove it from heat. You can have this dish with roti or rice of your choice, and it tastes absolutely divine. I'm sure you're going to love it. If you love this dish, then please give it a big thumbs up. Please do not forget to subscribe, and please do not forget to share if you like, because that will really mean a lot to me. And I will see you guys soon with more such recipes. Until then, take care. Bye.